you know, if you didn't figure this out from the first two tests, the initial review and then the follow-up long-term review, I'm really impressed with the VRC1000 cockpit. Again, I just have to say, one of the things that really impressed me is not just the workmanship of this, but that the guys really spend some time trying to get everything right. So after we had mentioned that there was no butt kicker mount, guess what? They now have a butt kicker mount that bolts right to this, and it's a it's really nice. They also came up with a drink holder that will fit right on your rig so that you can hold a drink. Now I found that you know, it's big enough, it holds it the way it sits, it doesn't really hold a cup of coffee that good, but it holds the water bottles really good. Actually, I don't know, I guess if you had your glass someplace else, you could even hold your wine bottle real good in here. But anyways, nice touch to be able to have a bottle of water right handy while you're doing your setups or whatever. And then the other thing that they've come up with, because when we did our initial review, there was no mount for the button boxes or the keyboard tray. So they've come up with a keyboard tray. And in typical fashion, it is a work of art. I mean, it's really, really nice. It just looks cool. A lot of thought went into it. Now, the problem I have is that I've mounted it here just so that we could put it here where you could see it. It really mounts on the hoop to where the monitor would mount on, or the TV, whatever you use for the front of the rig. It mounts on there, so it would be in a position a little bit higher than this. I've just put it here so you can see, because I did not use it for two reasons. One is it's a little too flexible for me, and as you can see, I like my stuff up high and tilted, so it's more like, you know, a continuation of a cockpit around here. So it just didn't really work for me, but I wanted to show you that it's a work of art, and trust me, I bet that they're already working on one that will mount and have some swivel adjustment to it. So again, the guys really do nice work with their VRC1000 cockpit, and they just keep adding these little niceties to it to where it's really what I would say is the upper end of regular cockpits for regular people, because it's affordable, you know, in my opinion. If you want the best without going full motion sensors and all that stuff, you'd be hard pressed to get something better than this. And again, not only does it work really well, but this thing looks great. Hey, so that's it. Until we got something new on this, I've been spending a lot of time working on setups, so maybe we'll do a video on racing setups and some more driving tips. I've been getting some people requesting, you know, new driving tips. We'll get to all of that soon. So until next time, Godspeed.